On previous videos, we've quoted out of Luke 14:33, which was dealing with in order to be a disciple of Christ, one had to forsake all. Well, we went through the breakdown of what that scripture means in its words, because when you go into the law of words and diction, the words that we use have definite meanings. Do not be fooled by people who tell you a word doesn't mean what it originally meant. We use diction for jurisdiction, so what we say in the court or we say anywhere will have a high impact on our lives. So to forsake all would be to forsake everything that was in common, because all meant what was in the aggregate, what we were assumed to be if we became a participant. So all is what's in common. You cannot transfer an inalienable position or property into an alienable. You can try to do it, but it would only be the fact is you're consenting to take on the use of someone else's property, not the fact that you're losing what you have. It's just you've confused the matter by merging two things together that do not belong. So in Luke 14:33, I believe the closest word to forsake was the word abandonment. It's very much used in the insurance agency. If you abandon something, then it is a complete loss at that moment. Therefore, it's gone. It's no longer yours. And therefore, if you claim it back, well, then there's an insured risk of what you're doing with it while you're in participation with it. That is really what's going on under the Social Security and the Social Insurance Program. It is being done properly. If you are using the property of another, then you may smart for it. You may be injured by it, and therefore you may have duty, debt, and obligation. And a debt can be a debt, even if the fact is you're not gaining anything by it when you do the breakdown and you realize later that you may not have had anything other than a debt. And therefore, it's just a treadmill that keeps on going on with more and more and more increased costs in order to operate within there. But if you've taken on a debt, which is what the surname represents, it represents nomen, name, debtor in the civil law, well then, how could you possibly use a name like that and say you're not a debtor? That's a complete ridiculous concept to deny what the reality is. And therefore, your Christian name is assured by Christ, and have you walked that way? Are you able to be exempt if you're a participant? Have you abandoned all? Have you basically stopped pursuing a secular life and now you're seeking first God's kingdom? Well, seeking first God's kingdom is according to Matthew 6:33. It said only if you were seeking first the kingdom of God would all other things be added to you. So even though you may not own them, technically in the world of the secular minds, you would be exempt from what others would have the duty, debt, and obligation to pay for, because you're not claiming them, because you have a spiritual viewpoint and you have a spiritual faith. And therefore, while your faith is still protected in most places in the world, you may want to look at what your direction is and what are you doing. If you're looking for exemption and you're still a participant, well, that wouldn't work. And therefore, have you communicated such? The following videos that we will do on these subjects are going to be the meat and the potatoes. And we hope that you listen and watch these videos and take the time with your family, go through the scripture and see whether or not you're fitting into those that are actually identified as God's people, those that represent peace, peacemakers, not people with war names, labeling names such as surnames that have beasts as labels that represent those arms. Would you be part of those recognized as a peacemaker? That will only be up to your own conscience after you watch the following videos. So we hope that this video clarifies again what a Christian basically should be doing in order to be identified as such. And certainly the identifying features of a Christian are clearly set out in Scripture. One being, of course, love, one being peace, and one not pursuing secular activities. I hope this video has helped you.